following UW360 story is made possible by the generous support of BECU. BECU, more than just money.
Then here and then to the battery.
This isn't just playtime. It could be nurturing an interest and confidence in a career in technology.
I need the two wires. I need the red and black wires. No, wait.
Researchers from the University of Washington's Institute for Learning and Brain Science have found that girls make up their minds at an early age about their abilities in STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math.
Sadly, by age 6, girls and boys already have stereotypes that boys are better at robots and programming.
We're finding that a lot of times the foreign-born people, they really like it.
Sapna Cheryan, an associate professor in the Department of Psychology, was one of the researchers. The team also found that early experiences with programming and robots sparked an interest and inspired confidence in young girls.
So what we were interested in the study is looking at young girls, 6-year-old girls and boys, and trying to figure out how can we get girls more interested in topics that they're not as interested in right now as boys are, for example, robotics and programming.
Okay, here's the next puzzle.
As part of the study, researchers guided 6-year-olds to use a smartphone to control a robotic animal.
For a lot of little kids, it's their first time programming something, and it's a really, you know, cute little robot, and you see them gain more confidence.
Researchers found that after completing this simple programming activity, the child's interest and confidence increased.
20 minutes engaging with a robot toy and programming this toy did successfully increase girls' interest and their self-efficacy, which is another way of saying kind of their beliefs that they could do well at programming and robotics.
We shared those findings with women in STEM fields, and they agree that love of science came at an early age, nurtured by family members and their own curiosity. Beatriz Medel is a UW freshman.
I remember my grandpa had this old radio, and he let me play with it, and I think that's what kind of like motivated me to go into that electrical engineering field.
Karla Herpoldt is a postdoctoral researcher in the Institute for Protein Design.
My dad is an engineer, and so we always grew up taking things to pieces.
And Brooke Fiala is a research scientist.
I set up little science experiments at home, putting sliced oranges in drawers and seeing how long they take to mold and everything, but my parents tend to get in the way of those sorts of experiments.
They all want to see more women in STEM fields.
With the right environment and the right programs, the right teachers in school can make such a difference. And something one day just clicks and you think, actually, I can do this. But you have to have a friend group that's supportive of that. You have to have peers who aren't gonna judge you for being the smart one or the nerdy one or whatever.
My goal is like, let's open up the field so that there are many different types of people who can put it on the table as a career and feel like it's something that they could do.
Connect this here. This is gonna work.
A smart toy could be a start.
Three, two, one.